What is the very best sim game of them all? Is it Elite Dangerous or is it Euro Truck Simulator? Today I will try to get an answer to that question. It's a tricky one, I will admit that. One can't just compare mechanics of those games, as they have little in common. Nothing, in fact. So I'm not going to do that. I have much better idea. I will stage a race between a truck and a spaceship, and the winner will hold the title of the best sim game ever made. See? Smart. What about Microsoft Flight Simulator? Shouldn't it be a contender as well? No. Planes are stupid. Unlike spaceships that are the future. And trucks are the backbone of society. Ask any truck driver, they will all say that our entire civilization would collapse if it wasn't for them and their jobs. So, how do we do this? Well, we can't race them on the same distance, as the spaceships, especially elite ones, are somewhat faster than lorries. Top speed of a truck in ATS-2 is about 130 km per hour, while the ships in Elite can reach velocities of several thousand times the speed of light. Therefore, the ship will be having a bit longer route to cover than a truck. Just a bit. The ship will start at the Galileo space station in orbit of an Earth's moon, and will then proceed to Mercury, where it will drop a ton of its cargo. And from there it will do the same for every single planet in order in our solar system. After that, it will head to the finish back at the Galileo station. The truck will be delivering its load from Międzyrzec to Wschowa in Poland, which is like 165 km. It will be driven on Fikcyjna Polska map by Matamet. It's a 1-to-5 really detailed and genuine representation of the real place. Every tree, every bush, every pothole, if it's there, it's in this map too. It captures the feeling and the vistas of the country so well that it actually feels quite eerie. Anyway, the thing that will finish its delivery first will be the winner. Representing Euro Truck Simulator, DAF XF, the most square-looking truck of them all. It's fitted with 410 horsepower straight 6 turbo diesel engine and automatic 12-gear sequential gearbox with a retarder. It will be delivering prefabricated stairs, a cargo truly vital to the survival of humanity. Representing Elite Dangerous, Falcon the Lacy Anaconda, outfitted with 7A thrusters and 6A frameshift drive. It will be delivering 1 ton of gold per planet. I'm through, and I'm your host for this event. Gentlemen, fill your cargo space. Ready? Steady? Go! And they're off. Let the race begin, and indeed, it has begun. Now, the track is already ahead on paper. 160 kilometers is now 15 trillion kilometers, which is roughly the distance ship has to do. But the track is slower, so it's anybody's guess who will win. Frameshift drive charged, and the ship is off to Mercury. Meanwhile, a red light has catched the track. This will cost precious time. Oh no, it's green now! That was close. When this was going on, the Anaconda almost reached Mercury. Glad the humanity didn't convert it into a Dyson swarm. It's such a nice little planet. And there it goes, 1 ton of gold. Probably it will be stolen by that pirate in the crate. No time to kill it, got to go to Venus as quickly as possible. Back to the track. There is no Venus, just mini roundabout ahead. No traffic though, the driver is lucky today. He's heading onto a highway, he will be able to put the hammer down there. He even joined the road without any delays, the ship may be in trouble. But for now it's at Venus, beautiful yet deadly planet that. Out of control greenhouse effect made it the hottest planet in the solar system. There goes the second ton of gold. It also rotates in opposite direction than other planets, not counting Uranus, back on Earth. Ooh, that was a mass Flynn. He ended up on the other lane. Good thing there was no one there. It was very dangerous. Oh, hey, look, there is a statue of Colonia Jesus over there. He is showing how much he likes ganking people. That much. The ship is back near Earth, not that far away from the truck, actually. The commander dropped another ton of gold, that one over Mexico. And he's off to Mars already, the last planet of the inner solar system and the seat of the Federation. The truck driver decided to overtake another lorry. It will take a while. Yep, still overtaking. And the crane too, people behind must believe it by now. There comes the bus. Not today. Scared him back, must be some kind of feud going on. Wait, that's Mars? Yes, it has been terraformed. Check this out, there's Spaceship One with President Hudson on board. Better to keep the distance, better to just dump the gold and head to Jupiter before the security gets trigger happy. This is the point where the ship can really stretch its legs and accelerate to mind-boggling speeds. The truck driver sticks to the speed limit though, either he's completely sure of winning this race or he has given up already. Back in space, the Anaconda passes the sun. The truck passes the overpasses. It's truly amazing how fast the ship can reach Jupiter. The commander looks very happy indeed. There it is, the king of the planets. We can see the famous red spot and faint rings over the horizon. And the gold has been jettisoned. Three more planets to go. Many people may be surprised to learn that Jupiter has rings, as it is very often portrayed in media without them. Back on Earth, the truck relentlessly keeps on moving forward. There are no obstacles in its way today. Will it be enough to win though? We shall see. Vehicles are joining the highway ahead, but that's no problem, they have been overtaken. Without any accidents too, the truck driver is in the zone, focusing on the road. And overshot the Saturn. I mean the ship, not the truck. The truck is still on Earth. I'm pretty sure it cannot overshoot anything. Back to Saturn. Commander has chosen to arrive in the rings. That's where the pirates lurk. Drop one ton of gold and those civilized people, they will eat each other, as we can plainly see. Just two more planets left for the commander. I'm kind of running out of things I could say about the truck. There's nothing going on there. Well, except the truck itself. There's the bus, still behind the lorry. Oh wait, the truck leaves the highway. It will now have to travel on a single lane road, clogging it up for everybody. Probably it will run over some animal as well. Uranus is in visual range now. The interesting fact about it is that the planet is tilted to its side. 98 degrees. Its poles being on the equator and rotating on the vertical axis. Second to last ton of gold has been ejected. Only Neptune left. Neptune. Huh. Neptune. Anyway, back to Earth. More precisely to Głogów, a small city where the truck is right now. There's a bit of traffic going on there, but nothing major though. It passes through it in a jiffy. He is not far away from the finish now. It seems it will be a close one. As it leaves the city, the spaceship releases its final ton of gold. All he has to do now is go back to the Galileo station. We are on the final stretch of the race now. Now the question is, who will make it first to the finish? A truck or a spaceship? We shall see. The spaceship have finished. It's back at the station. It won. Frameshift drive has beaten a diesel engine. Who would have predicted this? And the commander already celebrates the victory in the bar. Perhaps a bit too prematurely, as the race technically is not over yet. See? The truck still goes on. He's almost at the finish though. Back to the bar. Oh look, the commander argues with... yes, that's a Star Citizen fan. This can get ugly. The commander says that Star Citizen is nothing but a barely working pay-to-win massive scam that already has extremely bad influence on the worst practices of the gaming industry. Which is objectively kind of true, but the citizen is not having it. He pulls out the ship interiors card. The commander says he doesn't care that much for the ship interiors. Oh, he's one of those people. The citizen clearly can't believe his ears, so he goes even deeper with his argument. Star Citizen has trains and train interiors as well, he says. Meanwhile, the truck driver is in the visual range of his destination. Over there, just next to that train. Sadly, there are no train interiors in this game either. Where's the commander? He's back in his ship. He tries to blow up the bar with the Star Citizen fan in it. The station doesn't like that. He has been destroyed. This means he has been disqualified, as the race is still technically not over. Yep, the truck still didn't finish. So it's a win for Euro Truck Simulator. It claims the title of the best sim ever made. Even though it doesn't have track legs or trailer interiors, or a first-person shooter bolted onto it. Maybe with the upcoming Russia map expansion. Yeah, I can kind of see the logic behind it, but still unlikely. Congratulations! Now we just have to wait for the truck to actually finish the delivery. There's a man cleaning his Audi. Okay. The truck still needs to park in the right spot. What's the story behind that container? Probably a prank. Damn kids. And it's done. Finally. But Fru, what are you saying? We all should stop playing Elite and go play Euro Truck Simulator instead? No, of course not. Frankly, there is no point to this video. Well, if you want to stretch the logic, then maybe the point is that comparing video games is kind of stupid. I mean, I'm not going to make anybody play ATS2 and vice versa. Take for example No Man's Sky and compare it to Elite. Praise it all day long and I'm still not going to buy it. Cause I don't like it, no matter how good it is. So yeah, this video is absolutely worthless. Well, sorry for wasting your time then. But thanks for watching anyway. All 7.